Well, hello there, you two, and welcome to a 74-degree Saturday, the 27th of August. It's just going to be me today. Kelly's not here. Her dad, Papa, as you guys know him, is he's not doing well, unfortunately, and he's been in the hospital for the last few days, and she's going to visit him. She left here a couple hours ago or so. So she'll probably be, I don't know when she'll be back. But yeah, it's really sad. But these things happen. So I thought, just sitting here at the house, I've been flying drones around and playing with different things, and thought, well, before the day ends, because it's like almost 5 o'clock, let's take something for a ride. So today, that will be the GT650. All right, ooh, look at the dust on it. So let's roll on out. What do you think there, old GT, huh? Sasha. That's what I thought I'd try here for just a little bit here. This is a freshly chip-sealed road, but I've noticed that they've come through, and it appears that they swept them and then painted. Oh, my Lord. How about that? So I wonder what it's going to be. Wow. Well, at least it won't be an empty lot anymore. It'd be nice if it's something to do with cedar. I have no idea what it's going to be. Yeah, this has seasoned in quite nicely, actually. Look at this, all fresh road. You got to watch the turns and the little, you know, what I call the triangles of doom, where all the junk collects. Look at this, still got a lot of leaves in here. Starting to see things thin out here and there. I can't believe how quick this road is recovered. Usually, once they do this, it's always this, you know, kind of late summer when they do it. And that's pretty much it. They did a really nice job of coming and cleaning this up. Yeah, look at all that sitting in there. Oh yeah, I just heard one roll through the, when you hear them rolling through your fenders, you're going too fast. That was a pretty good buildup right there. You get to look out the side of this little place at a lower speed than usual. Then it clears out. This thing's got silver cases. They'll flip off them front wheels and then land, you know, in the track of the wheel, and they'll hit that hot motor. That tar just melts to it. That's when you're out with the toothbrush and WD-40 or something like that that'll soften up and dissolve tar. It's kind of a pain in the butt. But I don't have any, oh, that's a lot right there. Yikes. Obviously, it didn't sweep everywhere, right? Or I'm sure it just churned it up, people whipping through here. Something's missing. Oh, what the heck? Man, can you guys leave the godforsaken trees alone? Look all the way down through here. That explains the log trucks at 5 o'clock in the morning. Look at them. Look how big those trees were they cut down. Look how beautiful that barn is glowing in the light there. So did they run this thing all the way out, I wonder? I think they did, because last time I drove out here, you had all the little black patches where they filled in, getting ready to tar it down and gravel her, tar and feather the old road. I love this little, where you get that strobing effect when you're going through the trees. It's absolutely breathtaking. Think they're old GT. Yeah, buddy, they made this road nice. Hoping I wasn't meeting cars because I want to kind of stay in the tire tracks. Don't want to cross over the middle or of my lane. Yeah, they made this super nice. In a field. Just makes you smile inside, doesn't it? I love all the roller coaster humps you have through here. Stone stock suspension just works so good on this thing. It's a little soft. But I've always been one, even road racing. I've always set them up a little soft. My dirt bikes, I just ride better that way. I feel the bike instead of the bike, you know, bucking me. Getting gal on the horse. Look at the wind just blowing the trees. Love that. Tossing around feeling. Oop, gravel or yeah, gravel. Gravel with tar. Look at all the leaves on the ground. Absolutely lovely. Definitely not gonna dust this thing out by taking it down the dirt road here. You can see it looked like it rained. So you can tell where it bounced, and you know, fresh tire tracks where people come out here and turned around the squatchy turnaround. What do you think there, old GT? I'm gonna go blast it back down the hill. Ride your ride. I just want to stay out of that chip seal. I'm not worried about falling in it or anything. I just don't want it flinging all over my motorcycle. This thing's, I guess it does have that fender extension on the back. For some reason I was thinking it was like the iron and the slim, you know, it just like everything flies, you know. I'll keep you on while we go down the downhill here. Lovely, lovely motorcycle. Some of that's pretty thick. Should probably consider not falling in it. Seen them Dobermans in a while. There's that minivan that was always out there. Maybe they chased one too many motorcycles, and now they gotta keep them pinned up or tied up or something. That's a shame. Them dogs are having fun out there chasing them bikes. She's got her horse. I got my iron horse. The maintenance schedule on her horse, a whole lot more frequent on it than this. And these are pretty frequent. That's all right. Simple to do. Oh, motor in this thing just sounds so good. Man, that one that's set up for flat track. Oh, man. I mean, that'd be too loud for me to ride around, but it doesn't change the fact that thing sounded amazing, and it was fast. If they didn't have to do a restart, he'd have won that thing. And his rivals were the Hartleys. And ultimately, at the restart, there's only two laps. The dude on the Harley got him to the first turn, and just was enough time to rally up and get past him. What a bummer. Sorry about that. Woo! That turned the camera off for a little bit there. I'm seriously impressed, old GT. Holy moly. That's nice. Show that stuff on. Can't show that on TV. Holy moly. It's a little adrenaline going. That's nice. You just gotta do that every once in a while. Beautiful right here. None of the mountains were out. I never seen them the whole time I was flying the drones either. I tell you what, I'll talk about this stuff later, but I'll just throw it out here real quick. Because now that the Mini 2, it's like $450, I think, starting price on it. Of course, I highly, highly, highly suggest you buy the Fly More kit. And anyway, the prices come down on that. And there was crazy wind and literally no problem whatsoever. That thing's a trooper. You know, the camera on the Mini 3 Pro, excuse me, is obviously better. But it's not that much better that Mini 2 isn't phenomenal. It's still very, very fun to fly. There's no way that thing was handling that wind. I'm impressed. Oh, look at the birds coming up. Yeah, that's some big old bales right there. That's my hanging out of that automobile. Please tell me that's a dog or something. Oh no, it's just a reflection of the B-pillar. Wow, it looked like somebody was dangling out that window. I'm like, man, you like seven shades of crazy. Yeah, look at all them big old bales. You get over to Eastern Washington and other places, see these massive like cities of those things. Those are big, but really small compared to some of the ones you see. But anyway, hope you guys appreciated the little GT ride out in the country. Explore how the old chip seal roads are going. Doing really good. still got to be careful out there. I'll check her out, make sure nothing got anywhere. While it's hot, get it off. So, anyway, thanks for coming along for a rip. This is one of those clear my head rips today. All right. There was one tarred rock that landed right there in that center engine. Just some WD-40. I took a long screwdriver and knocked the big chunk off. WD-40 on a rag. While the engine's hot, it just melts and comes right off. That was the only place that had anything. Cool. I see some laying down in my skid pan, if you can make that out. But those won't be... melted to the skid pan, and if it is, next time I do change oil, I'll just WD-40 and rag and knock it off. That might be, what is that right there? That might be some more rot chunder. It looks like something old though. Definitely got a collection of stuff going there, don't I? All right, some more WD-40. Again, just that easy. She's gone. Just do it while she's hot. Don't let it sit there and bake in, if at all possible. You know, looking down the head pipes and stuff, you want to make sure those don't have, because it'll stick to them head pipes too, but it's flinging off the tire in a different way. And it wasn't very much. That was the best thing. It wasn't heavy and thick and flying everywhere. All right, let her sit out here and cool off for a bit. Text the little mama and see how things are going. Well, hello there, YouTube. Man, what a beautiful night. So, this is the last night of 2022 that sunset will be at 8 or later. Actually, if you look at the Weather Channel, wherever it's reading from, it says last night was it. But I've got two different apps that read the exact sunrise, sunset, and it's where you're standing. Where we're standing, it is 8:01 tonight. It'll be 7:59 tomorrow. Vancouver was 7:58 yesterday.
Yep.
So that's it. Man, once it drops past that 8 o'clock, it goes quick for some reason.
It does.
The next thing you know, it's 7 o'clock. Then right about the time it gets to 6 o'clock, the time changes. So you get, I don't know, a little bit into that towards the end of six, and all of a sudden, bam, it's 5 o'clock.
Yeah.
Dadgummit. Then
just leave the time alone.
It's dark for months.
Yeah, it does.
But anyway, thanks for coming along for the little rip, and I think we're gonna leave it at that. How about that?
Alrighty. Well, thank you guys so much for watching. We really do appreciate it. We will talk to you tomorrow. Same smoke time, same smoke channel. Don't forget to give her a thumbs up, and you guys have an amazing Sunday or Monday.
Between chainsaws and airplanes, man, we can't get no goodbye vlog done.
I know. It's just noisy out here today.
All right. We'll talk to you guys tomorrow.
See you in the morning.
Thanks for watching now. Bye-bye.